What up? Alright, so, first things first, this is a glitch hop tutorial, and I've been really into Virgil right now, and like all of his albums, and this little thing right here that I have was inspired off of this drop called Evil Game Boy by him, and it's like all glitch hop, and yeah, it sounds nearly exactly like it, so here's what the song sounds like. Yeah, see, you get the idea. All right, and now this is what mine is. So yeah, I'm gonna go through like everything on glitch hop from like what I know so far. So like this bass, and like, well, this is actually a Virgil Ride preset, and yeah, so like even like the backgrounds and all that. Yeah, and like the drums and stuff, it's just... So yeah, I'm gonna just open up a new project real quick, so I'll be back. Alright, so I just drug in samples right now, and I'm gonna set everything up. Alright, so the key thing for this is to have everything to be short and glitch hop. So you want all your sounds to be short, like basically, hang on, let me just do something real quick with my phone. Alright. Do Not Disturb is on, so let me just do kick snare real quick. So one, and actually, should we do 1-2? Yeah, 1-2. Alright, copy. We're just gonna do a 4, maybe even an 8. Alright, now that that's done, hat placement. So I just got this open hat, closed hat, my bad, and then open hat. I can. So, that's gonna go right there. For now, we're gonna keep it standard. I might even add another hat to, what's it called? I'm just gonna EQ this real quick. So you don't really need to see me do this. I'll just talk over myself or over it so that you got something to listen to instead of looking at. Because at this point, you should pretty much just know basic EQing of stuff if you have experience, but if you're new, It's not that hard. And I don't know if I'm talking too loud or too quiet, because I usually record through my my speakers, but I can't because I just updated my computer and the sound settings got all screwed up. But whatever. So I'm using headphones. So okay. Yeah, I want to add another hat because Virtual Riot does this awesome thing with like all of his hats. So let me just. Yeah, that's good enough. Just that first hat. Put that there. Slide you down. No, he does it like this. That's what he does. He does something like that, and it just sounds ridiculously awesome. So I'm just gonna delete all these other hats we placed. And then just copy these. So your everything just gets to be more full and more fun because glitch hop is fun and all that. And actually that was one genre that I was never fond of listening to, but it actually grew on me and I love it. So like that's the weird thing about glitch hop is also it's not coming to me, the tempo. Yeah, so amp, just gonna. Just want to put a dimension expander on there. Alrighty. Alright. So quantize all that and bring it down and EQ it. Sidechain it as well because you want everything to be clean. At least it can come down a little more. Actually, we're gonna do this as well. Okay, now that that's done, we can add sounds. So, here's what we're gonna do. And massive, gonna make the sound. All right, so what I did in here was I just made a basic bass and then I distorted the hell out of it using a Bronner tube. So, I'm gonna use like, Scrapyard. Scrapyard. Oh god, I can't get comfortable. Alright, here we go. Let's use like carbon. then let's use like AI. Okay, then I did some like modulation oscillation. What does just an octave sound like? Oh my. Alright, yeah, so like, alright, that, and then a pair of bog shaver. Now, put the drive all the way up. Then just to beef it up. Actually, we forgot pitch bend. Let's do that. So, that is a killer bass. Alright, let's just put something down real quick. You want it to be about the length of your kick or to your snare. So, and I'll do it real quick. Something like that. So, let me record something. Pitch bend, because I don't want pitch bend there. Changed my mind. But we do want it at zero. So we definitely want to sidechain this after we add a bass. But let's EQ it for now. I'll show you the EQ. Add new sound. I'm just gonna pull out a bass preset, so come here. Massive. Alrighty, virtual AI bass. I'm just gonna cut everything from here. So now you can EQ, sidechain it. All right, because I'm using headphones, I just need to boost that so I can hear it, because, and I'm gonna actually bit crush it too. So, if you have a sub, warning, because this is gonna be bassy. Alright, that should be good. Yeah, I can hear that now. What happens if we just do 100? Simple stuff makes me happy. No, no, no. Gang, gang, yeah, something like that. That's good. I'm gonna get that. All right. Okay. Oh, sidechain your hat too. Or anything that's over your drums, you need to sidechain. Get that virtual ride preset open, because that's a fun sound. It really is. Where is it? Hang on, let me find it real quick. Is it? I think it's this one. Yeah, that's it.
Bye.
I'm just editing this, so it's 1/8 on the amp. Okay, and you know those Skrillex womps, like these things, because those are actually also really good to use. No, this is... Yeah, I knew that was gonna happen. Sorry. That system overload. Oh, come on. It's not even that big of a project. It's because of the CPU eater. How much CPU is it taking up? Because the normal amount on massive alone is just 2. Alright, come on. Great, 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 great. 0. See, look at that. 3. Alright. 15 when you play it. Now let's open something like this. Because when you play it, I bet it goes up to about 4 or 5. Six, yeah. Yeah, so, all right, hopefully. Yeah, I'm gonna have to reboot Logic, so I'll be back. All right, I'm back. So this is what we're gonna do right now. We'll see what. It's not gonna quantize. Great. It means I actually have to freaking do it. Duplicate both of these and set them on different rates. So this one's going to be like an 1/8 because that one's a 1/4. And then we just need to do it with the bass as well. Put it underneath because that's on a 1/4. Alright, ready? Here we go. Actually, I'm gonna put that on a 12th and then shorten it and then put it on an 1/8. So, 16th. Yeah, I know it was. Which one? This one? 16th. So. And then maybe an 8th as well. Or not an 8th, 12th. Nah, we're gonna do 8th. So, gosh, this is a lot. Alright, 8th. This is 4. 4, 8, and then 16, 4, 8, and then 16. That'll make it easy. You end there so I can place you. Yeah, that sounds sick. Bum, bum, bum. That's awesome. And then I can add an eighth in there. Let's just drop you right here. You're a sub bass. I don't need the sub bass yet. Oh no, that's gonna be awful if we have it over top of that. All right, it's simple now, but we're gonna add some complex stuff in it, like those synths and stabs and that stuff. Actually, I wanna complex it up. Get it to be like dopey dope 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 stuff. So right at that half. But like with the fourth, and that'll sound freaking sweet. What the hell is this? No. Do I want an eighth in there? Because I'm not sure. Let me try the eighth really quick and then shorten it. Okay, yeah, that's cool for now. And then let me just open up Serum, because that's what I use for the synths, because Serum's freaking awesome for that. All right, so no. All right, we use chords and stuff. So both unison is, well, you're gonna do both 16, detune them. Solo on top of that is just gonna be freaking fun. So We don't want diminished. All right, so maybe F wasn't such a good key to choose for this because, well, there's nothing wrong with it. I don't know. It's just that F is a nice key. It's just that I currently don't want it because I'm not good with F keys or F chords. So let's just do that. Alright, no. Scratch it. We're not using this. So, menu, initial. Pluck. That's cool. I just don't really want to make my own. Thank you. Yeah, that sounds like Chinese stuff. But we're gonna do something like that, so. But it'd be good to quantize everything, so let's do that. That is freaking awesome. Keep the reverb high. Thank you. just gonna frickin'. How should I do that? Because I want to. No, that's going to be too fast. So yeah, I'm gonna layer stuff together and hopefully make something freaking amazing. So I'm gonna actually open up Serum for this one and get out this. I've used this before in a lot of stuff, so. It's just such a cool lick. Thank you. Nah, the recording will be easier. I don't want to do that. So. Come on, just reach. There you go. There we go. That sounds sick.
Thank you.
happens if I add a screecher over that 12? Let's see how that'll sound. So I'm actually gonna use that, oh! Hold up. This is a demo of this. I actually want to see how this sounds because I just got into these guys. They're pretty cool. Oh, whoa. Whatever. That is really quiet. Sorry, I'm like whamming on that. This is a complicated thing. It's not really. It's just getting to know stuff that sucks, you know? Alright, well that's pretty cool. What was I doing? Oh yeah, massive. Alright, so let me grab that zombie lead and then I'm gonna layer that with the like some dirty, so we go. 16th. But. That's in play because that would have been... Hang on, let me EQ it. I need reverb too because this needs reverb. Make something like some distorted thing, so let's just Bronner tube. Come on. Yeah, that's good enough. Yeah, so that sounds pretty cool. I'm gonna add in one thing and then I think I'm gonna call it a quits on it. Okay. This is awesome. Pretty much every freaking song I make. It's a rugby cheering crowd. And T and double that, so da and da and. Put you in there. Now, why we add this is because it's full of sound. So, yeah. Alright, how long? Hour and 8 minutes. That's pretty freaking good. Yeah, I think this is a pretty good tutorial on how to make glitch hop. Actually, no. We're not done. Lies. Don't listen to me. You know why? Because I'm going to add in. Hang on. I gotta find them. Where did I get those? Well, first we're gonna add some crashes because we never did that. So don't play, please don't play. This is also a really good one. So that's way down there, right? So we were chilling. Sidechain, of course. Definitely don't want these playing over top of your kick. Number four, that's really loud. Man, why can't I find those? That's really, really, really bugging me. Because they were like bell hits. Oh, I know where they are. There are my rides, okay. Yeah, there we go. Riggedy, riggedy ride. This adds a ton of, like, room and stuff. I usually put them on all the bases, where all the base hits are. I'm gonna EQ that. So you want reverb on mostly everything you have going on in your stuff, and you want high end out of everything going on. Yeah, alright, we're still not done yet because there's one thing that I also put in the other one, and it was a huh. So, oh god, that's gonna be hard to find. I think. Oh, no, it's not. Because I just found it. Chance. Use that what, this what right here. Actually, let's put that right there with you. That. Then I want to add another one, ho or hey. Let's do that one. Oh, hey, oh, hey, oh, hey. or something random like that. What effects have we got in here? This was a free thing, so. No. That's good. Actually, wait. That's a little thing. Oh gosh, come on. I can't even hear those frequencies. What if we double up on that? Some glitch material, because that'll sound baller. Nope. Yeah, sounds good. What else? 9's good. 9'll go on like stabs and that. Yeah, 11's freaking awesome. That's all we need. Alright, so. What was it? 9. Well, first, let's lower these all to a good volume. Let's put that at about 7. This could go down there. That could go down. Yeah, move it up. Thank you. So I think a good way to do with glitches is to have them all continuously go, like so that there's no stopping point with any of them. Yeah, all right. I think that's good. That is a pretty freaking good glitch hop tutorial. So, if you enjoy this video, you can like it, share it, do whatever the hell you want with it. I actually like YouTube does shows you like the analytics, and it shows me that older people watching my videos, which actually kind of surprised me because like it showed from like that 18 to 24 range, and I was like, whoa, so maybe like I don't know, actual like music producers or stuff like that look at it, which would actually be pretty awesome if they did. But anyways, yeah, my name's Cryptic, and thank you for watching me teach you how to make Glitch Hop. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.